Now, I know what you might be thinking. Wasn't this supposed to be the review of the empty ones? Yeah, but you know, instead of a traditional review, I decided to do kind of a mega comparison between the empty ones, the VK4s, and the EDXs. So we'll have to wait. But for now, as you could see from the title of the video, we are going to review the Blonde Mini. Let's start. Hello guys, me from the future here. So I don't know what the hell happened, but the footage got corrupted, so the unboxing is going to be cut short. I don't know again what happened, so yeah, sorry about that. Enjoy the rest of the video, I guess. And well, before we get started with the review, thanks to KeepHiHi for sending this unit for review. As always, links to the shop in the description. If you tell them that you came from my review, you will earn a nice discount. And this time I will have links to their website, which looks very cool. They've been working on it for quite a while and in my opinion looks very nice, very professional. And of course their AliExpress shop. And well, as you could see from the unboxing, you get a lot of things actually. You get your normal Blonde carrying pouch, which I lost, I don't know where it is. Obviously you get your IEMs and the cable, which is nice, finally a nice Blonde cable. And you get two sets of ear tips, the normal kind of boring normal silicone ear tips and these weirdos. And I don't know if you can see it, but it is kind of a spin fit, I don't want to say knockoff, but it is kind of a spin fit ear tip, you know. I call them Blonde fits because, you know, I'm very original. But yeah, these are super weird but nice. And well, you know, they might not look like much, you know, knockoff spin fits, but they actually play a very important role in the sound, which is what I'm going to talk about now. Sound quality. Or audio quality, whatever you want to call it. But right off the bat, this is a very, let's say, standard Blonde sound. So, you know, you get your nice bass extension, your kind of spicy treble, well, not so spicy, and sort of your very thick mids. But as always, let's start with the bass. So the bass on the Blonde Minis is, you know, again, very uppity, as we say. You get your soft bass extension, but soft bass isn't the cleanest. It sounds more like distortion rather than a vibration. It's weird to describe because soft bass is a very constant vibration that feels like a rumble, but with this you kind of hear it more than feel it, which takes a little bit of, let's say, musicality out of some songs, but not a deal breaker. Bass is accentuated, but doesn't affect the other frequencies. I think these have a little bit of a mid-bass hump, which gives them some thumpiness. But overall bass is on the kind of clean side of things. Not super natural in tonality, but compared to other Blonde IEMs, this is the best bass by far, if you prefer kind of a more clean bass. And what about the mids? Surprisingly, the mids are really nice. Again, I was hoping to get kind of a recessed mids, but actually no. The mids are kind of a little bit forward. Instrument separation is really nice. Vocals are a little bit, let's say, lean in presentation. They don't have a lot of warmth to them, especially female vocals, which for some might sound a little bit too forward and too aggressive, but overall vocals are excellent. There is a little bit of something weird going on, where instruments are kind of this in the same level. In some of my songs, instruments are by layers, you know, you have your main instruments and then you have another layer of instruments. What the mid does is that it brings those instruments kind of on the same level, so it sounds a little bit weird, as if kind of
The instruments were standardized, let's say. But aside from that, again, MIDIs are excellent. I really like them. And now I've realized that I haven't given you a close-up of these, which look really odd, but I like them. What about the treble? Treble is a little bit on the spicy side of things. There is some emphasis on it, but it doesn't sound super aggressive or intimidating, let's say. With the standard ear tips, you know, the ones that are in like spin fits, treble is not the best, let's say. You don't get a lot of sparkle, so it might sound a little bit dull. But with these spin fit like ear tips, actually treble is really musical. Yes, it is forward and emphasized, like I said, so for some of you, that might sound a little bit too hot, but for me personally, it is in that threshold of being painful and being dull. Cymbal strikes and all of that aren't aggressive at all. They are forward, but not aggressive, is what I'm trying to say. So treble is well behaved, but with a little bit of spiciness added. So, summary of all the nonsense that I just said. This is very standard blunt tuning. You know, it's V-shaped. So emphasis on the bass, emphasis on the treble, but that doesn't mean that this is a normal sounding V-shape IM. I don't know if that makes sense. This sound signature is really, really nice. It is on the aggressive side, but it has some nice musicality behind it. So it's not just, you know, a super hot treble, super strong bass, and not detailed at all. But don't get me wrong, it is not perfect. Bass again. Soft bass is not the cleanest. Bass doesn't have the best tonality, in my opinion. Mids, vocals feel a little bit, let's say, too clean. I don't know if that's a term. Instrument separation is nice, but you know there is a little bit of weird forwardness going on. And treble can be overwhelming for some. It is very, very close of being sibilant and thin, but it is in that threshold. It's a really nice, warm, and musical sound signature. The best blown, in my opinion, so far. And well, what about build quality? Because build quality has really improved. Again, you get your standard, let's say, carrying pouch. This is a Cavier, I know. It's the same as the B01s, but here they are. So this is the blown mini in a close-up. As you can see, I have the silver color, which looks really nice. I almost like all the silver looks. Here you have a little bit of text, which I don't mind, but you know, this is going to wear out with time. This is a 2-pin connector. And here, you can barely see the micro diver there. This is kind of a deep fitting IM. This is your ear tips, which are really nice. I wouldn't bother with the other silicone ear tips because they are very standard, but these kind of spin fit ear tips are really nice. And like I said previously, this cable is really good. You have here your straight plug with some text, a little bit of cable protection, and this is not braided. As you can see, it has like a silicone coating and it feels really, really soft. It is a really well behaved cable, but it tends to kind of keep memory for a while. You know, if you have this stored and kind of wind up, when you later use them, they are going to be kind of coiled a little bit. Here you have your 4-cut splitter, whatever you want to call it. Again, a very nice cable and a mic, which sounds standard, you know, nothing out of the ordinary, but usable. And you get here to the ear hook, which still has that aggressive kind of preform ear hook, but in this case it doesn't affect fit at all. In fact, it helps. So build quality is much better than previous blunts, and that's one of the main causes as to why I like this more than previous blunts, because all those came with a very bad cable, like one of the worst, and fit was kind of crap, but the minis have improved in all of those fronts, which is really nice. And well, what about gaming? For gaming, these are okay. Treble seems to be a little bit too much for gaming because gunshots, explosions and all of that sound too aggressive for me, in my opinion. Again, mic is usable, but since these are kind of deep fitting IMs, you are going to get a lot of your own voice in your head, kind of thing. If you want to see how that feels, plug your ears and start talking, and it's kind of like that. So it's not a very pleasant feeling. But again, for gaming, it is really nice. Soundstage is impressive for, you know, the size of the driver. Imaging is adequate. It's not, let's say, it's not the strong suit of this IEM, but it is a little bit above average. So for gaming, these are usable. Not my first option, but usable. And well, general summary of all that I said. These are really nice. I feel like I said that a lot, but these are actually surprising. I was expecting kind of a sound signature very similar to that of the Zero Ones, which if you have seen my video, I liked, but I have some mixed feelings about it because fit is not really that nice also. But that really, really improves with this. I was going to get kind of a worse fit than with the Zero Ones, but all the opposite. Fit really improves. I know that sounds kind of weird, because these look like they are going to be kind of a pain in the butt to use, but believe me, it is actually really nice to get a good seal. The ear tips provided are really nice, even the silicone ones, which are very standard, but the spin fit like ear tips that Blum provides are really, really nice, and they help the overall sound signature. You know, you get your Opti bass, the mids are really nice, the treble is well behaved. Again, if you are treble sensitive, take into consideration that it might sound sibilant and thin to you, because it is almost for me, and I'm kind of treble sensitive, but anyways, nothing that EQ can solve. But that would be pretty much it. Again, if you're interested in buying this, I will have links to Keepify shop and website, so you can check them out and buy them, because honestly, these are really nice. And for the price, man, these are a steal. These are really nice. These are really nice, I think, for $30 or something like that. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. And next review, I promise this time it is going to be about the empty one. So see ya.